What's up everybody, welcome to Gaming Tech. As you see, I have my tools here. We're back with the computer content, starting the day with coffee first. Afterwards, a fortune cookie. It says it's going to be an exciting experience. Let's find out. Basically, in this video, I will be disassembling a PC. This case will be using another system. We have the Svive electrostatic mat here to basically protect the components here. Silanos MS Ragentech case. It comes with two 200mm fans on the front. Wearing gloves, since I don't want to make it dirty. As you can see, I had some fingerprints from previous use before. The system is with 12600K RTX 3060 Ti. Screwdriver that I'm using is a ratchet one. So as you see, you can hear from the sound that I can twist left and right or lock it on the manual. Very cheap one actually. I think I paid like $15 for it.
Two of them. That's for the side panel.
From Xiaomi. I wanted to see how the experience is with the tool. That's why I use it. Normally I use electric ones.
As you see,
it's quite compact case. Here you can see the system. That is the smallest RTX 3060 Ti ever. For some reason this panel was loose, no idea why, but you can see it's fairly simple. Just building the PC just takes time.
Do I label the screws? No, because I know this case. But if I was unsure, I would definitely unlabel stuff.
Hopefully you guys are getting a good view of exactly what I'm doing. There's nothing complicated whatsoever. Afterwards, I will remove the graphic card. We will put all of the components aside and make a room to unscrew everything else.
As you see, we have these two.
That support bracket is basically locking the graphic card. Normally, it should be super tight. Perhaps here the screws weren't making good contact enough.
It's loose.
Graphic card here is a great card for a mini ITX system, by the way. Quite powerful enough.
Let's see.
Gotta use this chopstick here to remove the graphic card because I cannot touch that plastic PCI Express pin there.
You see, guys?
There's not enough space to click on that mechanism.
We remove
front panel header. We removed. Basically, I'm removing everything here, one by one, carefully. USB 3.1 and 24 pin. I will remove as well.
Fans.
Just remove the fan header there.
There we go. Okay.
If you use these zip ties, this is the problem you're gonna have. If you intend to change your case or do something else. Luckily, I didn't use many here. And I have seen people, while they try to cut the zip tie, they end up cutting the cable. So be careful when you do that.
All right.
Had to remove the fan.
That cable, I don't want it to hold it there.
Because I cannot access these 8-pin cables here for the motherboard.
Now, the next one. God damn, that camera.
There we go.
If it's actually filming.
Sadly, I don't have much space on the table also. So I keep flipping and changing the orientation of the case.
Affordability is an important factor.
And this tool is only good for using where you have enough space to work with, basically.
motherboard in one go.
And here I will remove the motherboard. Once we remove those 8 screws, afterwards power supply, 4 screws. Very simple.
There we go.
The blue sleeved cable is from Corsair, older generation.
Love this tool. It's actually really useful.
They still don't have the same level as cable mod, even on the newer versions. Sometimes you can scratch the power supply while you try to remove like this. It was a little bit dusty. I won't unplug the power supply cables because it will directly go to another system.
Freaking spider nest here, man. Ridiculous.
There we go. Right. Just removing the necessary cables there. We had a SATA connection
Everything's there. So tiny. Most likely something else is connected here since...
Case itself is very compact and easy to work with.
Nice.
There might be some zip ties holding some stuff that I might need to cut. As you see, to the right, we have the RTX 3060 Ti graphic card. We have the motherboard itself with the cooler. Till the new case comes, I pack everything so it doesn't collect dust. I have all of the necessary tools on the table along with the coffee. How are you guys doing, by the way? Comment below. Let me know how you guys are. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, do so, and thank you for your support, everybody. I welcome the new subscribers as well. Here was a mess with the front panel cable, the USB cable, the audio cable. Had to sort them out later on, so they will look more tidy.
So,
other than that, I like this case a lot. Simple, nothing complicated. Can move it with one hand. I'm just going to install this fan here. Other than that, job is done. I'm happy. Didn't take that much time to do it, basically. With my own case, I will be cleaning. It's gonna be a long video for sure, because the problem is, first of all, when you have custom loop, the system is heavy. That's one thing. Then you have radiator, then you have fans attached to the radiator, which where it collects insane amount of dust. It's very unpleasant to clean, especially if it's an open case. That's why I will have a dedicated video for that. So if you're getting into an open case, you should know the positive and the negative aspects of it. If you do everything in order, it's gonna be very simple. As you see, I have the parts on the right side. On the left side, all of the stuff I removed. And boxes were on the floor, so original stuff goes where they came from. Alcohol wipes, didn't have any. Normally you use these for monitors. Just gonna wipe it, clean it, and repack it.
Okay, let's see.
And then we will use this case for another project. I won't spoil it, so you'll have to wait and see. Work is done. Thank you for watching. Have a great day, guys. Take care of yourselves. Let's go.